Yeah.
Thank you.
Andiamo giù.
Da Uma, i migranti li Papa Francesco seku tifrita. Ama hom prezent ukoll numru ta' rappresentanti ta' dik mhux governattivi li jagħmlu ħidma Malta fost migranti u r-refuġjati. الجبل الجبل
Beatissimo Papa Francesco, è una immensa gioia, è un grande onore accoglierla in mezzo a noi. La sua presenza ci conferma nella fede in Gesù e ci incoraggia ancor di più a metterci a servizio di coloro che soffrono e che necessitano della nostra vicinanza, della nostra cura e del nostro conforto. Nessuno vorrebbe lasciarsi alle spalle la propria storia e i propri affetti. Ma la guerra, la fame e l'impossibilità di costruire il proprio futuro e quello dei propri figli spinge tanti uomini e donne a fuggire della loro patria e a cercare un luogo sicuro. Sappiamo che queste persone, indipendentemente dalla razza o dalla fede religiosa, sono figli di Dio, destinatari del suo amore incondizionato, tenero e amorevole. Siamo consapevoli che come cristiani siamo chiamati ad offrire loro in modo concreto accoglienza e possibilità di vita e i suoi pressanti appelli ad essere vicini al più deboli ci spronano a fare sempre meglio e a continuare la nostra missione quotidiana verso quanti, per un tempo limitato o permanente, sbarcano sulla nostra isola per fuggire dalla miseria e per avere una vita migliore. Anche per questo motivo, grazie per la sua visita, Santo Padre.
Caro Papa Francisco, I am Daniel and I come from Nigeria. I left my hometown 5 years ago, and after 13 days of traveling, we arrived at the desert. While crossing, we passed dead people and animals, burnt cars and a lot of empty rubber cans. And after 8 traumatic days at the desert, we made it to Libya. Those who still owed money to the smugglers were locked up and tortured severely until they made their payment. Some lost their lives and some lost their senses. I was lucky enough not to be among them, not that I was too smart. And at that time, Libya was in great turmoil. Flying bullets became my steady companion. And we were surrounded by violence. So to travel from one place to the other, we were loaded like sardines just to conceal us from the police. We were at risk of being kidnapped at every moment, and I paid smugglers twice. I was promised to be put on a boat to Europe. But then the trips were canceled, and I never got my money back. The conditions were really terrible and unhygienic. But then I managed to find the work as a plasterer in Libya, and then I got to pay for another crossing. I got into a boat, 2 by 10 meters, and we were over 100 people. We sailed for over 17 hours before an Italian ship came and rescued us. I was excited, I was so full of joy. People were kneeling, they were thanking God. Only then we discovered that the boat were actually sailing back to Libya. They handed us back to Libyan Coast Guard and we were put in prison. I was there for about a month, and then I started to work for a Libyan policeman as a plasterer. He gave us food and he gave us shelter. He was really kind, and then he set us free on the condition that we will work for his brother, but that his brother will get to pay us, although we later escaped from his brother because he refused to pay us. 9 months later, I was again on a boat. During the first night, we encountered high waves. Four of us fell from the boat, even with my eyes wide open, my hands widely open. I couldn't rescue two of them. They went down the Mediterranean. I almost lost hope. We were all scared to death. I slept, and I hoped to die. I woke up the next day. Things were calm. People smiling again, and fresh hopes starting to rise again. We continued to sail again until we met some Tunisian coast guards, fishermen actually. They gave us food, they gave us bread, and they gave us water. They had told us they would help us call for the rescue, and eventually the ship arrived. But we found out that it was the Tunisian Coast Guard, and we couldn't resist to enter, because it was better than spending another night in the Mediterranean. We landed, and we were taken to Zaziz, Tunisia. We were given food, we were given clothes, and we were given shelter by the NGOs. I remember having to write "Don't quit" with a toothpaste on my wall close to my bed. And one of the staffs always told me to come and clean it off, but I refused. Until the day he came around and he told me he wouldn't leave until I get to clean it. He brought a rag alongside, and then I did. He came back the next day, and then he found the landscape I had drawn on the same wall with my pen. Then he later brought me papers and a pen. And from then I drew more. I drew more. I fell in love with art. I even got to work with a Tunisian artist for a bit before I returned to Libya with two others on foot. Some would say, why did I go back to Libya? But then I went there because it was easier to cross from there rather than Tunisia. I started to work again until I earned enough money to pay for yet another try. And this time I put all my hope in this one. This time at the sea, after 3 days, I made this to Malta. This was the sixth time I had paid smugglers. It was all smiles when the Maltese Coast Guard rescued us. I couldn't believe my eyes. Tears of joy flowing freely. It was a dream come true at last for me. But these were short-lived because we were put in detention the same night we landed in Malta. I was heartbroken. I almost lost my mind. Most nights I cried. I asked God why. Sometimes I just wished I had died. I started to wonder if all the journey was a mistake. Why were men like us treating us like criminals instead of brothers? And after 6 months, we were brought to an open center here at Hafar, a few meters away from here. It took me time to adapt because the tension has drained me. Within weeks, I started to get better. I started a new life with the hope of getting better. And thanks to everybody who made this possible for me, everybody that offered me a helping hand along the way. And then my thoughts go to all my brothers and my sisters who are still in custody. And every time I ask myself, when would they obtain their own freedom? Thank you, Papa, for listening to me. Unfortunately, still today, many persons who escaped from war and famine have a story similar to mine. Thank you.
Carissimo Papa Francisco, my name is Sirman Koulibaly. I have been in Malta for the past 4 years, and my wife is expecting a baby. Thank you for choosing to meet us here at the Peace Lamb in Halfar. Not many people in the world know about this place. Halfar has been a living place for many of us migrants in Malta. We know it well. For many of us, it's a place of invisibility, a place of no being. None of us leave our homeland because of lack of love for our countries. On the contrary, our journeys are journeys that start in hope and finding a safe space. We fear war, violent conflict, violation of human rights. Few realize that also living, cultivating a dream in our own heart to reach a land where violence is unthinkable. We are people in all their diversity are accepted for who they are. Our dream is called freedom, is also called democracy. We believe in this. Many of us thought that Europa is that kind of place. When you run away from a situation of war, conflict, extreme poverty, you have nothing except for your determination to live a better life and a lot of courage and resilience to face all the challenges you encounter. Unfortunately, many of us are not seeing in the fullness of their humanity. Many appreciate our struggles and our refuge for yours. However, others take advantage of the vulnerability of the people who are struggling and are in the desperate situations. Women, men, children, and accompanying children easily become victims of exploitation and abuse are not treated with the dignity every human being deserves. Unfortunately, many of us are not seeing the fullness of their humanity. Many appreciate our struggles and help us to find safe refuge. However, many exploit the vulnerability of those who are struggling for a better life. Women, men, children, and accompanying minors easily become victims of exploitation and abuse and are not treated with the dignity every person deserves. Human dignity is not always taken for granted. Many of us have experienced that on their own skin. For many teens, many years of suffering and uncertainty. The fullness of respect of all human rights is an upward struggle that continues in many countries. Today, we want to remind people in decision-making position and who hold the power that human rights and dignity are universal and inherent. They are acknowledged and respect never given. We are fraternity to thee, right? Amongst other things, I'm referring that the way we are treated when we, the lucky ones, manage to reach safely and we spend a long period of time with little information and living in the uncertainty of what our immediate future holds. There are people whose asylum claim has been rejected yet still cannot go back to their country for origin as it is still dangerous to them to do so, to refer that as the sans-papiers, and end up stuck with little or nowhere to go, with little or no rights at all. These are not just stories and numbers, but they are us, people in flesh and blood, faces some with broken dreams, others who have managed to achieve them. We know that we are aware for this situation and that you are strong voices for our struggles. We know that your love is not lip service, but sincere. And that is why we are here together in Halfar with my brothers and sisters and representative of organizations that offer service to us here in Malta. I thank you for your tireless work for us and for the love and respect toward our dreams and aspirations. I never imagined that together with my brothers and sisters, I was going to be spoken to the Pope Francis in Halfar, of all places. What great joy. Dear Pope Francis, we thank you even for this. Your love is life to us. Thank you and gracias. Thank you also to Malta.
sorelle.
Vi saluto tutti con affetto. Sono contento di concludere la mia visita a Malta stando un po' con voi. Ringrazio padre Dionisio per la sua accoglienza e soprattutto sono grato a Daniel e a Seriman per le loro testimonianze. Ci avete aperto il vostro cuore e la vostra vita e nello stesso tempo vi siete fatti portavoce di tanti fratelli e sorelle costretti a lasciare la patria per cercare un rifugio sicuro.
I greet you heartily. I feel so happy that I am concluding my visit to Malta by spending some time with you. I thank Father Dionysius for his welcome, and most of all, I'm grateful to Daniel and Sirmian for their testimony. You opened your hearts and lives, and at the same time, you were a voice for so many brethren that leave their countries to find a safe place.
Come dicevo qualche mese fa a Lesbo, sono qui per dirvi che vi sono vicino. Sono qui per vedere i vostri volti, per guardarvi negli occhi. Dal giorno in cui andai a Lampedusa non vi ho mai dimenticato. Vi porto sempre nel cuore e siete sempre presenti nelle mie preghiere.
As I had said some months ago in Lesbos, I came to tell you that I am close to you. I am here to see your faces, to look into your eyes. Since the day I visited Lampedusa, I never forgot you. I carry you always in my heart, and you are always present in my prayers.
In questo incontro con voi, migranti, emerge pienamente il significato del motto del mio viaggio a Malta. È una citazione degli Atti degli Apostoli che dice «Ci trattarono con rara umanità». Si riferisce al modo in cui i maltesi accolsero l'Apostolo Paolo e tutti quelli che insieme a lui erano naufragati nei pressi dell'isola. Li trattarono con rara umanità, non solo con umanità, ma con una umanità non comune, una premura speciale che San Luca ha voluto immortalare nel libro degli Atti. Auguro a Malta di trattare sempre in questo modo quanti approdano alle sue coste di essere davvero per loro un porto sicuro.
In this meeting with you migrants emerges fully the meaning of the motto of my voyage here in Malta. It is a quotation from the Acts of the Apostles that says, "The inhabitants of the island treated us with utmost kindness." It refers to the way how the Maltese welcomed the Apostle Paul and his companions who were saved from shipwreck near the island. They treated them with utmost kindness, not just with kindness, but with great kindness, with special fondness, humaneness, which St. Luke wanted to leave inscribed in the book of the Acts. I wish Malta would always treat in this manner those who arrive on its shores, that it truly becomes for them a safe harbor.
Quella del naufragio è un'esperienza che migliaia di uomini e donne e bambini hanno fatto in questi anni nel Mediterraneo. E purtroppo per molti di loro è stata tragica. Proprio ieri si è persa la notizia di un salvataggio avvenuto al largo della Libia di soli 4 migranti in un'imbarcazione che ne conteneva circa 90. Preghiamo per questi nostri fratelli che hanno trovato la morte nel nostro mare Mediterraneo e preghiamo anche per essere salvati di un auto naufragio che si consuma mentre succedono questi fatti. È il naufragio della civiltà che minaccia non solo i profughi, ma tutti noi. Come possiamo salvarci da questo naufragio che rischia di far affondare la nave della nostra civiltà? Comportandoci con umanità, guardando le persone non come dei numeri, ma per quello che sono, come ci ha detto Sirman, cioè dei volti, delle storie, semplicemente uomini e donne, fratelli e sorelle, e pensando che al posto di quella persona che vedo su un barcone o un mare alla televisione o una foto, al posto suo potrei esserci io, mio figlio, mia figlia. Forse anche in questo momento, mentre siamo qui, dei barconi stanno attraversando il mare da sud a nord. Preghiamo per questi fratelli e sorelle che rischiano la vita nel mare in cerca di speranza. Anche voi avete vissuto questo dramma e siete arrivati qui.
Shipwreck is an experience that thousands of men and women and children endured during these years in the Mediterranean. Even yesterday we received news of a boat which where four only were saved amongst the number who were drowned, more than 90. Unfortunately, for many of them it has ended up tragically. But there's another shipwreck that occurs when these events happen, the shipwreck of civilization. And we need to ask the Lord and pray for those who are ending up tragically and also for our civilization that risks to get in shipwreck. It threatens not only those who leave their homeland, but all of us. How could we get rid of the shipwreck that risks destroying the ship of our civilization? By acting humanely, by looking at these persons not simply as numbers, but as what they are, as Sirmian told us. That is faces, stories, simply men and women, brethren. And by thinking how instead of the person that I am seeing at sea or watching on television or in a photo, I could be there, or my son or daughter. Perhaps even now, as we are here, there are boats faring the sea from south to north. Let us pray for these, our brothers and sisters, who are risking their lives at sea, searching for hope. You also live this tragedy and have arrived here.
Le vostre storie fanno pensare a quelle di migliaia e migliaia di persone che nei giorni scorsi sono state costrette a fuggire dall'Ucraina a causa di quella guerra ingiusta e selvaggia, ma anche a quelle di tanti altri uomini e donne che, alla ricerca di un luogo sicuro, si sono visti obbligati a lasciare la propria casa e la propria terra in Asia, in Africa, nelle Americhe. Penso ai Rohingya. A tutti loro vanno il mio pensiero e la mia preghiera in questo momento.
Your stories make us think of thousands and thousands of people who in the last days had to escape from Ukraine because of an unjust and savage war. But also the stories of many other men and women who, in order to seek a safe place, were forced to leave their homelands in Asia, Africa, and in the American continent. I think particularly of Rohingya. I think of them all, and for them I wish to pray now.
Qualche tempo fa avevo ricevuto da questo vostro centro un'altra testimonianza, la storia di un giovane che raccontava il momento doloroso in cui aveva dovuto lasciare sua madre e la sua famiglia di origine. Questo mi aveva commosso e fatto riflettere. Ma anche tu, Daniel, anche tu, Siriman, e ognuno di voi ha vissuto questa esperienza di partire staccandosi dalle proprie radici. È uno strappo che lascia il segno. Non solo un dolore momentaneo, emotivo, lascia una ferita profonda nel cammino di crescita di un giovane, di una giovane. Ci vuole tempo per risanare questa ferita. Ci vuole tempo e soprattutto ci vogliono esperienze ricche di umanità. Incontrare persone accoglienti che sanno ascoltare, comprendere e accompagnare e anche stare insieme ad altri compagni di viaggio per condividere, per portare insieme il peso. Questo aiuta a rimarginare le ferite.
Some time ago I received another testimony from your center, the story of a young man who recounted the moment of sadness when he had to leave his mother and family of origin. This touched my heart and made me think. You too, Daniel, also you, Sirmian, and each one of you has lived this experience when having to leave and sever oneself from one's roots. Such tearing leaves a scar, not only the pain at that moment, emotionally, it leaves a deep scar in the development part of a young person. Time is necessary for such wound to heal. Time is required, and especially are needed other humanely rich experiences. One meets persons that are welcoming, are ready to listen, understand, accompany, and also be with others doing the same journey, to share and carry the burden together. This helps to heal these wounds.
Penso ai centri di accoglienza, quanto è importante che siano luoghi di umanità. Sappiamo che è difficile, ci sono tanti fattori che alimentano tensioni e rigidità. E tuttavia in ogni continente ci sono persone e comunità che accettano la sfida, consapevoli che la realtà delle migrazioni è un segno dei tempi dove è in gioco la civiltà. E per noi cristiani è un gioco anche la fedeltà al Vangelo di Gesù, che ha detto: ero straniero e mi avete accolto. Questo non si crea in un giorno, ci vuole tempo, ci vuole tanta pazienza, ci vuole soprattutto un amore fatto di vicinanza, di tenerezza e di compassione, come è l'amore di Dio per noi. Penso che dobbiamo dire un grande grazie a chi ha accettato tale sfida qui a Malta e ha dato vita a questo centro. Lo facciamo con un applauso tutti insieme.
Welcoming centers come to my mind. How important it is that they be places of humanity. We know how difficult it is, there being many factors that increase tension and rigidity. Notwithstanding, in every continent, there are persons and communities that accept the challenge because they know that the migration reality is a sign of our times and it is an issue of civilization. And for us Christians, it is an issue of being loyal to the gospel of Jesus, who said, "I was a foreigner and you welcomed me." We do not accomplish this in a day. It takes time, a lot of patience, and most of all, love given through closeness, kindness, and mercy, as is God's love for us. I think we should say a big thank you to whom has accepted this challenge here in Malta and gave life to this center. Let us do this by an applause.
Permettetemi, fratelli e sorelle, di esprimere un mio sogno, che voi migranti, dopo aver sperimentato un'accoglienza ricca di umanità e di fraternità, possiate diventare in prima persona testimoni animatori di accoglienza e di fraternità. Qui è dove Dio vorrà, dove la provvidenza guiderà i vostri passi. Questo è il sogno che desidero condividere con voi e che metto nelle mani di Dio, perché ciò che è impossibile a noi non è impossibile a Lui. Ritengo molto importante che nel mondo di oggi i migranti diventino testimoni dei valori umani essenziali per una vita dignitosa e fraterna. Sono valori che voi portate dentro, che appartengono alle vostre radici. Una volta rimarginata la ferita dello strappo, dello sradicamento, voi potete far emergere questa ricchezza che portate dentro, un patrimonio di umanità preziosissimo, e metterla in comune con le comunità nelle quali siete accolti e negli ambienti dove vi inserite. Questa è la strada della fraternità e dell'amicizia sociale. Qui c'è il futuro della famiglia umana in un mondo globalizzato. Sono contento di poter condividere oggi questo sogno con voi, così come voi, nelle vostre testimonianze, condividete i vostri sogni con me.
Allow me, my brothers, to express a dream I have, that you migrants, after having experienced the welcome full of humanity and brotherhood, may also become witnesses and animators of acceptance and brotherhood. Here is where God wants you to be, where providence led your steps. This is a dream that I share with you and which I put in the hands of God, because what is impossible for us is not impossible for Him. I feel greatly the importance that in today's world, migrants become witnesses of human values that are essential to a dignified and brotherly life. These are values that you carry within you, which are part of your roots. When the wound would have healed from its rupture, from the roots from where you were plugged, you may be able to bring out this richness that you carry within, an inheritance of a very precious humanity. And you put it in communion with the communities within which you were welcomed and the environments where you are now inserted. This is the way of brotherhood and social friendship. Here we have the future of the human family within a global world. I am happy today to have been able to share this dream with you, same as you, in your testimony, shared your dreams with me.
Mi pare che qui ci sia anche la risposta alla questione che sta al centro della tua testimonianza, Sirman. Tu ci hai ricordato che chi deve lasciare il proprio paese parte con un sogno nel cuore, il sogno della libertà e della democrazia. Questo sogno si scontra con una realtà dura, spesso pericolosa, a volte terribile, disumana. Tu hai dato voce all'appello soffocato di milioni di migranti i cui diritti fondamentali sono violati, purtroppo a volte con la complicità delle autorità competenti. E questo è così. E questo voglio dirlo così. Purtroppo a volte con la complicità delle autorità competenti. E hai richiamato l'attenzione sul punto chiave, la dignità della persona. Lo ribadisco con le tue parole. Voi non siete numeri, ma persona in carne e ossa, volti, sogni a volte infranti.
I believe here lies also the answer to the issue that is at the center of your testimony, Sirmian. You reminded us that whoever has to leave his country leaves with a dream in his heart, the dream of freedom and democracy. This dream clashes with a difficult reality, often dangerous, sometimes terrible, inhuman. You gave a voice to the suffocated appeal made by millions of migrants that their fundamental human rights have been violated upon. Unfortunately, at times, with the complicity of the competent authorities, I want to say it in this manner, at times, with the complicity of the competent authorities. And you highlighted the key point, the dignity of a person. I repeat this using your words. You are not numbers, but persons with a body, having blood, faces, dreams, at times shattered.
Da questo si può e si deve ripartire, dalle persone e dalle loro dignità. Non lasciamoci ingannare da chi dice non c'è niente da fare. Sono problemi più grandi di noi. Io faccio gli affari miei e gli altri che si arrangino. No, non cadiamo in questa trappola. Rispondiamo alla sfida dei migranti e dei rifugiati con lo stile dell'umanità. Accendiamo fuochi di fraternità intorno ai quali le persone possono riscaldarsi, risollevarsi, riaccendere la speranza. Rafforziamo il tessuto dell'amicizia sociale e della cultura dell'incontro, partendo da luoghi come questo, che certamente non saranno perfetti, ma sono lavoratori di pace.
We can and need to start from here, from the persons and from their dignity. Let us not be tricked by those who say nothing can be done. Such problems are too big for us. I care for myself and the others care for themselves. No, let us not fall in such a trap. Let us answer to the challenges concerning by way of humanity. Let us ignite bonfires of brotherhood around which persons can warm themselves, get back on their feet, rekindle themselves once more with hope. Let us strengthen the social friendship fabric and the culture of acceptance, starting from places like here, which certainly would not be perfect, but they are laboratories of peace.
E perché questo centro porta il nome del Papa San Giovanni XXIII, mi piace ricordare quello che egli scrisse alla fine della sua memorabile enciclica sulla pace. Cito: allontani, Signore, dal cuore degli uomini ciò che la può mettere in pericolo, la pace, e li trasformi in testimoni di verità, di giustizia, di amore fraterno. Illumini i responsabili dei popoli affinché accanto alle sollecitudini per il giusto benessere dei loro cittadini garantiscano e difendano il gran dono della pace. Accenda le volontà di tutti a superare le barriere che dividono e ad accrescere i vincoli della mutua carità, a comprendere gli altri, a perdonare coloro che hanno recato ingiurie. In virtù della sua azione si affratellino tutti i popoli della terra e fiorisca in essi e sempre regni la desideratissima pace.
Given that this center bears the name of Pope Saint John 23rd, I am pleased to remind what he wrote at the end of the memorable encyclical on peace. May the Lord distance from the heart of humankind that which could hinder peace, and make of them witnesses of truth, justice, and brotherly love. May he enlighten the leaders of peoples so that together with the good they perform, they may also guarantee for their citizens and safeguard the huge gift of peace. Finally, may he ignite the will of all men to crush the walls of division and increase in them the bond of love which unites, so they may understand others and forgive those who trespass against them. Thus, through him, the peoples of the earth, through peace, the peoples of the earth unite, and in them may flourish and reign evermore the so much desired peace.
Cari fratelli e sorelle, fra poco, assieme ad alcuni di voi, accenderò una candela davanti all'immagine della Madonna. Un gesto semplice, ma con un grande significato. Nella tradizione cristiana, quella piccola fiammella è simbolo della fede in Dio ed è anche simbolo della speranza. Una speranza che Maria, nostra madre, sostiene nei momenti più difficili. È la speranza che ho visto oggi nei vostri occhi, che ha dato senso al vostro viaggio e vi fa andare avanti. La Madonna vi aiuti a non perdere mai questa speranza. A lei affido ciascuno di voi, le vostre famiglie, e vi porto con me nel mio cuore e nella mia preghiera. Anche voi, mi raccomando, non dimenticatevi di pregare per me. Grazie.
Dear brothers and sisters, in a moment, together with some of you, I will light a candle in front of the statue of Our Lady. It is a simple act that carries a strong meaning. In the Christian tradition, that little flame is a symbol of faith in God. And it is also a symbol of hope. Hope that Mary, our mother, shall assist in the most difficult times. It is that hope that I saw today in your eyes, which gave a meaning to your voyage and helps you walk forward. May Our Lady help you never lose this hope. I entrust each one of you and your families to her, and I will carry you with me in prayer. And you also, do not forget to pray for me. Thank you.
Preghiamo insieme il Signore. Signore Dio, creatore dell'universo, sorgente di libertà e di pace, di amore e di fraternità, tu ci hai creato a tua immagine e hai infuso in tutti noi tuo soffio vitale per farci partecipe del tuo essere in comunione. Anche quando abbiamo infranto la tua alleanza, tu non ci hai abbandonato in potere della morte, ma nella tua infinita misericordia sempre ci hai chiamato a ritornare a te e a vivere come tuoi figli. Infondi in noi il tuo Spirito Santo e donaci un cuore nuovo, capace di ascoltare il grido, spesso silenzioso, dei nostri fratelli e sorelle che hanno perduto il calore della casa e della patria. Fa che possiamo donare loro speranza con sguardi di gesti di umanità. Fa di noi strumenti di pace e di concreto amore fraterno. Liberaci dalle paure e dai pregiudizi per fare nostre le loro sofferenze e lottare insieme contro l'ingiustizia, perché cresca un mondo in cui ogni persona sia rispettata nella sua inviolabile dignità, quella che tu, Padre, hai posto in noi e il tuo Figlio ha consacrato per sempre. Amen.
Thank you. Thank you.
Devo passare, vieni, vieni.
Pensa qui.
Attenzione, sono bambino. Sì, io non c'è.
Pensa qui.
Attenzione, 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 di qua, di qua.
Thank you.
Okay, you too.
Okay,
outside. You can stay here.
Thank you.